Favorite Amazon finds for your desk setup. So I've put together a few products that I think you guys should maybe consider for your desk setup. I'm not saying you should go out and buy all of them, but there are a few interesting new products here that I found recently that I wanted to cover and share with you guys, because there's always new stuff coming out, right? And on this channel, I love to cover the latest tech and gear. So these are some new things that I've discovered recently that I think you guys should check out. So first up is the Logie Keys to Go 2. And I found this completely by accident. I just was randomly looking online and I just saw this and I was like, that looks quite interesting. So I bought it, and yeah, a really impressive keyboard. This keyboard is specifically designed for traveling. It comes in this fold out case design, which I think is pretty smart. It protects the keyboard, especially when you put it in a bag. It's very small and compact. Here it is compared to a standard sized keyboard, so you can see the difference. It's also very thin, similar to sort of Apple's Magic Keyboard. The typing experience is okay, like it's not going to come close to like a proper mechanical keyboard, but if you're used to something like a Magic Keyboard from Apple, this is actually fairly similar. I also like how they've included a compact row of function keys, as I use the function keys all the time. And the one thing that blew my mind, and I had to double check just to make sure it was actually true, was that Logitech are claiming up to 3 years of battery life. 3 years of battery life from a, I think it's a coin battery, one of those coin batteries. That's absolutely wild. How can this thing last for 3 years? Like, that's absolutely blowing my mind. So yeah, if you are looking for a compact keyboard that you can take with you on the go, you're someone who travels regularly, this is a really good choice. Next up is the P-Stand case for the iPhone by Toras, who are also sponsoring this video. Toras make a bunch of different phone cases, with the P-Stand being one of their latest. It's inspired by the sort of scissor doors of a sports car. It has a kickstand that is designed to hold your phone up at an angle, whether it's portrait or landscape. The kickstand is also very satisfying, not gonna lie. It feels very premium and it folds in and out with ease whilst also feeling solid. It sits flush inside the case too, so it doesn't stick out. The case is of course still MagSafe compatible. It has Toras's patented N56 magnets to ensure a powerful magnetic strength. Of course, the case is also designed to help against scrapes and drops. The material feels like a mix between sort of rubber and TPU, but it still feels premium, which means it should do a great job against minor drops. I have a few colors here, with the black slash gray colorway here, of course, being my favorite. I also like how it's translucent. It has that sort of transparency look that's very trending amongst other products right now. So make sure to check out the P-Stand from Toras. I'll leave a link to it down in the description below. Next up is the Native Union laptop stand. So in my latest desk setup video, I shared this new laptop stand that I got from Native Union. I've recommended 12 South on the channel in the past, but this is a new laptop stand from Native Union, and as soon as I saw it, as soon as I saw the styling and the design of it, I just knew I had to have it because it just looks awesome. It's made from metal and fabric and feels super premium, and I think for the price that it goes for, it's actually incredible. I love products like this where they value sort of design and aesthetics alongside functionality. You can of course adjust the height and angle to whatever is comfortable for you. And there's a tray on the bottom where you can put a phone and a pen. I just think it's an all-round very stylish laptop stand. If you're looking for something that can look cool on your desk, this is definitely one of the best looking ones. Next up is the Anker MagGo 3-in-1 charger. If you're looking for a multi-device charger that's fast as well as aesthetically good looking, Anker have the new MagGo charging stand. I have the black version here, but it does also come in a lighter colorway, and it's perfectly designed for pretty much any desk setup. You can charge an iPhone, an Apple Watch, and AirPods all at once, but the iPhone charger is Qi2 certified, which means it can charge an iPhone at the full 15 watts, double the standard 7 watts. Same with the Apple Watch charger, it's MFW certified, so it can fast charge an Apple Watch. I also really like the look of it. I think they've done a good job of making it look somewhat premium, but also, you know, quite techy. And I think for the price, it's very good value. I also like how there's enough room to rotate your iPhone so you can utilize standby mode. An awesome multi-device charger. If you're looking for something that can just charge all of your devices all at once on your desk and also look quite sleek, this is pretty awesome. Next up is the Xiaomi light bar. And it's a budget monitor light bar that does not feel budget whatsoever. I was very impressed with this light bar when I first unboxed it because of the fit, the finish, and the materials. it just makes it feel very premium. There's a USB-C port at the top for power, and I was able to simply plug it directly into the USB port on my monitor. What I like most though is the included control knob, which is completely wireless. It can be clicked to turn the light bar on and off. You can rotate it to adjust the brightness, and then to adjust the color temperature, you simply hold it down and then rotate. So if you're looking for some sort of light to light up your desk, some sort of monitor light bar or anything like that, I think for the price that this goes for, it makes a lot of sense. Next up is the Logitech Lytra Beam LX. So this is sort of similar to the Xiaomi light bar that I just mentioned, as it's a light that goes on your desk. However, this is more specifically designed for streaming. It's a dual-sided LED light that on one side has a key light that is designed for lighting up your face on streams or anything like that, or video calls. But on the other side, there is an RGB LED light that can be used for accent lighting. And of course, it can be doubled up as a sort of desk lamp, which is mainly what I use it for, because of course, I'm not always streaming and I'm not always on video calls. So when I'm not on those, I just sort of rotate it and have it as a desk lamp. Next up are the Sennheiser IU100 Pros. So I've mentioned these on the channel numerous times already in the last few months, but I really do feel like if you're at a desk and you need some good quality earbuds that you can use for video editing or listen to music or just sort of audio monitoring or anything like that, for $100, these are absolutely incredible. I actually like them so much that I end up buying another pair. So I had the clear colorway here, which I think looks awesome, but I also had the simple black colorway. Yeah, the clear colorway, like, these are some really good looking earbuds. I primarily got them for high quality audio monitoring when I'm editing video, but the sound that comes out of these things when just listening to music or watching movies and stuff like that is so good. I found that the bass, the mids, the highs, there's very good separation between all of them. The bass especially, I was really impressed by how much bass these produce. I have found though that the rabbit hole for IEMs can go quite deep, because you can end up spending thousands on some in-ear monitors. But for $100, I really do think these are some of the best value, and I feel like if you can afford a $100 pair of earbuds or headphones or whatever, like, these are definitely a pair to consider. Next up is the CalDigit TS4 dock. So if you're someone like me who has a MacBook, it can of course be quite limiting because you only have a few ports on the MacBook. So I like to use Thunderbolt docks. This is CalDigit's latest one, the TS4. And as far as I'm aware, this is one of the only Thunderbolt 4 docks that you can get right now. And yeah, it is incredible. I don't think it's necessarily like the best looking dock. I do think there are some better looking docks out there, but CalDigit have definitely favored functionality over form. On the back, there is a 2.4 gigabit Ethernet port, 4 USB-A ports, 3 Thunderbolt ports, an audio input and output, 1 USB-C port, and a display port. On the front, there's an SD and micro SD card reader, a headphone jack, 1 more USB-A port, and 2 more USB-C ports. This dock is not cheap though. It does go for $400. So it's definitely targeting a niche category of people. It's very much, I feel like, catered to people who have professional sort of workstations, professional desk setups, where, you know, they have a high-end MacBook and they need to connect up lots of peripherals, and they want to make sure that all their peripherals run at the sort of most power, most speed that you can get. So it's not something that I feel like everyone really needs, but if you are someone like me who has lots of different peripherals, lots of different accessories, especially Thunderbolt accessories, like I have Thunderbolt drives, I have Thunderbolt monitors, things like that, it makes a lot of sense to get something like this, because then you don't have to worry about running out of ports. Next up, we have the Logitech Lift mouse. So if you're someone who struggles with traditional mice where your palm is sort of facing downwards towards the desk, this is a mouse that I would highly recommend that you should check out. Most mice would usually be like this. You know, you'd usually be holding it like this with your palm down. But with this, your hand is more of a natural position. So for a lot of people, this can actually be a lot more comfortable and a lot easier to use. So if you are someone who struggles with wrist problems, hand problems or whatever, I think it's carpal tunnel or whatever, I would highly recommend checking out something like this, the Logitech Lift. There are some other ones as well, but for the price, this is actually very, very reasonable. And it's also weirdly quite aesthetic looking. I feel like it almost looks like a piece of art in a way, because it just doesn't look like any other mouse. Logitech have done a good job of making this mouse look like something that actually looks cool, rather than some sort of contraption on your desk. So that's it for this video. Some of my favorite desk accessories. I will of course leave links to everything down in the description below. If you guys have any suggestions of products that I should check out, that I should cover on the channel, maybe something you've bought recently that's cool, please leave it in the comments below. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter and subscribe for more.